time now for Movies and Money. Joining me, our film critic, Erik Childress, the Chicago Film Critics Association. Yay, it's almost Friday. So let's talk about what's coming out at the box office. And Dory was dominant last weekend. Will Dory win again?
I think it will, actually. Finding Dory opened to $135 million last week, exceeded many people's expectations, and it became the biggest animated opening weekend of all time, there's no reason to expect that it's not going to do number one business again this weekend. It's probably going to be somewhere over $250 million by the time this weekend is over.
Our editor loved the film. I think maybe his kids liked it too, but he loved
sure.
the film.
Mm-hmm.
So adults are really enjoying it.
Well, that's the Pixar model. I mean, they make movies, you know, they're made for families, not just kids, not just for adults. They're made for everybody. And, you know, especially parents who can have a sort of an emotional connection with not just their own children, but, you know, having parents of their own. And that's what the Finding Nemo and Finding Dory movies have really excelled at, and the Pixar movies in general. And even though I don't think this is one of their best efforts, but it's certainly a good effort. And in this summer, good is good enough.
It's not hard to love a blue fish. And we talked about the summer slump.
Mm-hmm.
And as you expected, some people are saying this is the film that could take us out of the slump. But you disagree with that, correct?
Well, I disagree with the fact that there are some people that, you know, if you look at the movies on a week-to-week basis, between this summer and last summer, yes, the box office is down a couple of $100 million. But there's one sort of important fact that a lot of people are forgetting about, is that last year, the box office summer started on May 1st. This summer, it started on May 6th. So there's a five-day difference between them. So if you go week to week, you're looking at a couple $100 million off last year's pace. But if you go day to day, and if you look at just the first 42 days of this summer compared to last summer, the box office is actually only down $13.1 million.
Okay.
So that's a very significant, you know, number to look at. And now in the next few weeks, you're looking at last year, there were weeks that were filled with over $300 million spent at the box office. In one case, $400 million, four of the next 5 weeks, actually. So this year has a lot to look up to compared to last year. So you might see that number start to expand a little bit, but there are some movies that are going to hopefully keep it close.
Let's see if it can happen this weekend. One of the films coming out this weekend happens to be Independence Day, Resurgence.
Your father was the bravest man I've ever seen.
We all lost someone we love.
Yeah, and this is sort of a very interesting movie to talk about. On one hand, the semi-good news is that it's probably going to open as well as the original movie opened. The problem is that original movie opened 20 years ago. So the inflation...
Has it been 20 years?
It has been 20 years since Independence Day. And
oh,
we're going to
see
exactly how many people are still interested in doing another alien invasion movie, you know, connected to the original. And this is actually a movie that Fox has failed to screen for critics, at least here in the U.S. They've screened... for some press internationally, but in the U.S., they've withheld press screenings.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, and that's never a good sign. And you remember back in May when X-Men Apocalypse came out, they actually screened that a few weeks in advance for critics, and it kind of backfired on them. They lifted the embargo a couple weeks early, trying to sort of get the jump on Captain America, and they ended up getting a ton of really bad reviews and a lot of really bad press. And even though the movie has gone on to gross over $500 million worldwide, it is going to be one of the lesser grossing X-Men movies here in the U.S. It's actually about $80 million less than the last X-Men film did. So people were not very happy with it. We're going to see what Independence Day does. I think you're probably going to see this do, at maybe at best, half of what the original made.
What do you think about The Shallows?
The Shallows is sort of interesting film, you know, opening in the middle of the summer, in that it's, you know, it's not a very big budgeted film. It has a very simple concept. You put Blake Lively, a surfer, in shallow waters with a bunch of sharks. How is she going to survive? Very simple, you know, logic there. Very something that people can describe to their friends in very few words. And I think that this movie has potential to be one of these small little breakout hits. Not like maybe like a $100 million film, but the kind of movie that, you know, ends up making like 50, maybe 60 million along the way. We're going to see the projections this weekend are wildly kind of all over the place. There's some people saying under 10 million. There's some people saying close to 20 million. I'm more in the middle. I think the movie is going to do some pretty solid business this weekend.
And finally on our list today, Free State of Jones.
No man ought to tell another man what he's got to live for. or what he's got to die for.
I don't have the patience with five or six deserters hiding out in a swamp.
And this is a movie that you would expect would come out more around the Oscar season. It's a Civil War story based on a true story starring Matthew McConaughey as this farmer in the Civil War who basically rallied a bunch of black men and women to basically fight for their rights. So it's not getting good reviews at all. It was moved from a May release date to the end of June here, kind of hoping to maybe capitalize and maybe just some adults looking for some more adult entertainment. But the reviews have not been good. The Rotten Tomato score is very, very low, and I expect you're probably not going to see a lot of box office here, and it's just not the right time, and apparently not the right movie.
Okay, good to have you here. Thank you, Erik.
Thank you.